Good evening.
Good evening.
Testing, testing, testing. Testing two, three. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Jeremy Winston. I am the Director of Worship and the Arts here at Kettering Seventh-day Adventist Church. And on behalf of our senior pastor, Dr. Carl Hafner, and the rest of the pastoral team, we want to welcome you to this evening's concert. A couple of housekeeping notes as before we get started. We have a very packed house, and so if you can, especially those on the floor, if you can press in as much as you can to make some room for those that are still coming in, try your best, try your very best. It's a good thing. It's a good problem to have a packed house. And since you're here this evening, I assume that you love choral music, so I would just like to take a second and let everyone here know that Kettering Seventh-day Adventist Church is preparing for their candlelight service, Christmas candlelight service, on Friday evening, December 14th, and we're still having rehearsals, so if you're still interested, there's still time. We have rehearsal every evening, every Wednesday evening at 6 o'clock. We could have it every evening as well. We can have a week full of concerts. But no, every Wednesday evening at 6 p.m., and we are very excited to host the Oakwood University Aeolians. This is a sponsored concert, a joint sponsorship between Kettering Seventh-day Adventist Church and the Kettering Health Network Mission Weekend. And so we're very excited to have them here. The Oakwood University Aeolians, if you're not familiar with them, then we're happy that you've come out of your rock and come out here this evening. But the Oakwood University Aeolians were crowned the Choir of the World in Wales in 2017. And in 2012 and 2018, were gold winner champions at the World Choir Games in both Cincinnati and South Africa. And so I can say without a shadow of a doubt that you are in for an outstanding evening of worshipful music. I say that as a musician myself and also as a proud graduate of Oakwood University. So thank you so much for being here this evening, and we hope you enjoy the program.
Thank you.
Happy Sabbath, Kettering. I know it's Sabbath, so we can't show you. Oh, wow, look at the balcony, it's full. Wow. We can't express enough how excited we are to be with such friendly and familiar faces and to sing in such a wonderful space. I've often said I wish we can take this space to everywhere we went. That way we can ensure we always sound pretty decent. We want to move to a song now that expresses a lot of praise and a lot of thanksgiving. And it will be in the Latin text. We don't want you to get lost. Jubilate Deo. And I will quickly move to another piece. It's called The Potter's Clay, or Keramus, by a composer that lives in nearby Indianapolis, Mr. James Mulholland. And then we move to a third piece called The Promised Land. Everyone say Promised Land. And this piece was composed by a dear friend of ours across the pond in London, England, Mr. Kent Burton. If you saw the movie The Black Panther, Wakanda Forever, Ken was actually the choir contractor for that movie, so his name appears in the credits. And a wonderful musician that has performed multiple times for the Queen and engagements such as that. So Jubilate Deo, Keramus, and Promised Land.
Jubilate Deo, miserere, Jubilate Deo. We've got some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter to me now, for I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind like anyone else. I'd like to live a long life. Longevity has its place, but I'm not concerned about that right now. I just want to do God's will. He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. I've looked over and I've seen the promised land. I might not get there with you, but I want you to know that we as a people will get to the promised land. That's why I'm not fearing any man. I'm not worrying about anything. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Trust that you felt the pathos and the passion behind that piece, yeah? It moves me every time. Someone came up to me the other day and said, wow, that was so Trinidadian what I just did. Y'all heard that? Someone came up to me the other day. Someone came up to me recently and said, you know, it'd be cool if you guys do a whole entire program on Negro spirituals. That'd be really, really awesome. Maybe one day we will. But this set now, I want to sing some Negro spirituals. Let's do Hold On. let me process that. We haven't done that in a lot of years. What was I saying? Hold On. And one of my favorite spirituals, Steal Away to Jesus. And let's do another one. Oakwood is famous for having that group Take Six to come out of his doors. And one of the founding members of that group, Mervyn Warren, back in 1985, wrote a song in the style of a spiritual called I Ain't Got Long to Be Here.
Keep your hand on a dove.
I'm going to apologize in advance for the simplicity of this next song. And sometimes it's those songs that are the most memorable, yeah? There was a guy by the name of Robert Friesen who died over a decade ago. And he's the guy that wrote the song, God is the Joy and the Strength of My Life. Does anyone know that song? And there's another gem that he wrote, and it's actually in the African-American hymnal, a simple song, but a powerful message. And hopefully by the time we do a section one or two times, you'll catch it. Just feel free to jump in, okay? Seriously, glorious is the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
have it yet? You can sing, His Spirit.
His Spirit.
His Spirit has control.
Can't you feel
His warm embrace?
His warm embrace.
And oh the joy.
And oh the joy.
Within your soul.
Within.
What's his name? What's his name? From the Rising. No piano. We can do this a cappella. He's worthy. This next song perhaps needs no introduction. But it's a song that means so much to us. So much to so many people that have heard this song. And I think it's a song that has some words that speak to our social climate. Speaks to all the division that seems to be happening. And it ultimately speaks of getting out of this place and getting to another place. And sometimes I just love to recite the words just in case you miss it when we sing. There's an old song by Charles Tinley that says simply this. He says in his verse 1, he says, "Beams of heaven, as I go through this wilderness here below, guide my feet in peaceful ways and turn my midnights into days. When in the darkness I grope, faith always sees a star of hope. And soon from all life's grief and danger, I shall be free someday." Another verse says, "Burdens now may crush me down, and disappointments are all around. Trouble speaks in a mournful sigh, and we show our sorrow through a tear-stained eye. But there is a God who rules above. He has a hand of power, but a heart of love. And if I am right, he'll fight my battles. I shall be free someday." And the chorus to the song simply says this, "I do not know how long 'twill be, nor what the future holds for me. But this I know, that if Jesus leads me, I shall get home someday." We sing this and we'll take a short break and we'll be right back and finish this program. Thank you so much for sticking with us. You've been a lovely audience so far.
Thank you. Wow. What a blessing. How do you say anything after that? Just by way of introduction, my name is Tom Onyuka. I'm the executive director at Good Neighbor House. And on behalf of Good Neighbor House, I want to thank Kettering Seventh-day Adventist Church and Kettering Health Network for graciously allowing Good Neighbor House to benefit from the love offering that is going to be taken up in just a few moments. For those of you who don't know, Good Neighbor House is one of the ministries of Kettering Seventh-day Adventist Church, along with several other Adventist churches and other churches in the Dayton area. And we provide medical, dental, eye, thrift store, health and wellness classes, and we just reach the community and help those who are in need. And I want to just mention, before we take up the offering, a little story about the picture that you see. Last week, there were some workers from the city that were tearing down the bus stop that is right on the edge of the parking lot at Good Neighbor House. And I was a little bit dismayed because I was wondering, where are the people going to stand? Because they're going to have their food that they have and their things that they have. They're going to have to stand in the rain. And then on Monday, I drove up. And as I drove up, I noticed the city had put up a bus stop that had Good Neighbor House written on it. And I'm thinking, praise God. God is so faithful. It's because of the faithfulness of His people that support the work of Good Neighbor House and reaching out into the community. The city has recognized that we are there. And at nighttime, there's actually a solar panel on top. And when I drove this week, left at nighttime when it was dark, it was lit up. And it reminded me of how, because of your faithfulness, Good Neighbor House is a beacon of light in a dark world. So I just ask that you would be generous as you give tonight. And we ask the deacons to come forward. Thank you.
Choir's getting ready to come back in, and I think they're going to come down the back aisle, so let's make sure we create some space for them. But if you're enjoying this concert this evening and you just can't quite get enough, we invite everybody to worship with us tomorrow morning at 11:15, where the Aeolians will be singing again. So you're welcome to be back here again tomorrow morning at 11:15 to worship with us in the full service. And we'll get a chance to hear more of the Oakwood College Aeolians. So thank you so much, and I'll always be back with Dr. Jason Ferdinand to finish up this concert this evening. Have a good night.
at first death. Come ye over waters, and he that hath no money, come ye by and eat. I heard the voice of Jesus say, behold, I freely give the living water, thirsty one, stoop down and drink and live.
I heard the voice of Jesus say, behold, I freely give the living water, thirsty one, stoop down and drink and live.
I came to Jesus and I drink of that life giving strength. My thirst was quenched, my soul revived, and now I live in Him.
I came to Jesus and I drink of that life-giving stream. My thirst was quenched, my soul revived, and now I live in Him. My thirst.
Oh, everyone that
ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise His name, I'm fixed upon it, name of God's redeeming love. Hitherto thy love has blessed me, thou hast brought me to this place, and I know thy hand will bring safely home by thy good grace. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger, bought me with His precious blood. Daily I'm constrained.
first voice that you heard this half was that of Mr. Mark Simons, who hails from the Maryland area. Mark, take up another bow. And right next to him, the voice you just heard all the way from the Bahamas, Mr. Louis Clear. I'm going to actually do something perhaps a little strange for the middle of a concert, right? But I want to actually take your phones out. Take your phone out. Some of you have it out anyway. Just take your phone out. And find a couple of people that you really love and adore and just text them, say, you know, I want to tell you that I... No, I'm serious. Do it. Take 20 seconds and do that. And as you're doing that, many times in weddings we hear this hymn, O Perfect Love, yes? That hymn is sung, and I've never heard that song outside of the wedding setting, but if you really look at the words of that song, it speaks to so much more than a matrimony ceremony. And we want to do that now. That's why I'm asking you to send that to someone you love so you can get it in your head. There's a special arrangement done by one of our young faculty members. Where is Steve right now? Is he in the room? Steve, could you stand up for me, please? This is Professor Stephen Murphy. Who is a genius in his own right, and I feel privileged to have taught him all the way from high school through college. Went to do his master's, did some touring, and now he's back at joining our faculty, especially in the theory area. So this is his setting of O Perfect Love. stunning arrangement?
Gosh.
Man, it's amazing. Let's stick with some hymns, and I'm going to drive this home to a close in a second. How many of us know the hymn Blessed Assurance? Woo, yeah, can we sing it together? Wayne, I don't know, a D flat or C or something? I don't know. Let's do C. Y'all know what you're singing with me? Blessed Assurance, Jesus. Oh. Oh, what a foretaste of glory God, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born in His Spirit, washed in His. This is my story, this is my story, this is my song, praising, praising my Savior. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Man, it's not Fanny Crosby, yeah? And a musician out in California, Mr. Byron Smith, who is predominantly known as a gospel Hammond organist, has taken this hymn and put a little spin on it. Hope you enjoy it.
Oh.
Oakwood is really known for, Take Six. And a few years ago at the NBC sing-off, we had the group Committed. And now we have a different group, all guys in the Aeolians, called A Different Effect.
Test, test, test.
Good evening, everyone. Like Dr. Fernandez said, we are The Different Effect, and we're going to sing a song called Lord Give Us Time. This arrangement was by my father, and what this song means to me is not only time for to give everybody else time to, you know, be saved, but it's also time to let us be changed by the Lord. So please enjoy. Thank you.
Lord, give us time to tell our sisters and our brothers and our brothers.
tradition continues at Oakwood. Good harmony music, Mr. Willis.
Good to see you. You know who Chris Willis is? Yeah, that's his father. You could see it, right? Oakwood legend. I'm going to bring this to a close, and there are a few people in the audience I just must mention, a whole lot of people. There were two ladies that walked in while we were doing the first half, and they had to leave. I'll mention them anyway. Kim and Lori, you know, I thought about this the other day, and Villaroy, you could help me with this. It's because of Kim that since 2012 that we've kind of gotten so much of the exposure that we have. Kim Mann was working at the time for the World Choir Games, and in 2012 it was held in Cincinnati, right down the street, right? And we had no idea who Kim was. Kim kept calling my office, and I kind of passed on to Villaroy, because she kept calling, and Villaroy said, man, this lady is talking about something we should probably check out. I'm like, man, I don't know about anything about that. We literally decided to do it like late April. This thing, the deadline was long past. The deadline was December or something. They let us in, and we went to Cincinnati. And it was because of Kim, that non-Adventist friend of ours, who's opened so many doors for us to World Choir Games. And we just came back from South Africa, which I'll talk about in a little bit. And Kim and Lori, they came. They played hooky from another event to come here to hear us, and they had to run back. So, Choir, I know you want to thank them. You saw them outside. So let's thank them in absentia. Yes. And then I cannot say enough about the team here at Kettering, Pastor, and Fred Manchur, who I feel like I know very, very well now. That's an inside thing. He knows what I'm talking about. And all the friendly faces here, like really, we love coming here. And it's because of you, in part because of you, that we were able to take that trip this summer to South Africa. Because they were one of the corporate sponsors. So we want to thank you for it. I was asking, I wasn't... Okay, I guess it's too late now. She's already on her way. This is Ms. Sherry Wilson, who serves as our Executive Director of Advancement and Development. And... You want to say something?
I just got off the road, so I'm a little embarrassed, but but on behalf of our president, Dr. Leslie M. Pollard, all the administrators, faculty, staff, and students, thank you so much. Where's Mr. Manchur?
Right here.
Oh, hi, good to see you. Thank you so much, Kettering Health Network, and all of you. This has just been beautiful. We thank you so much for your support, for your love, your prayers, and we just hope you enjoy this weekend as we will. And thank you, Jason.
And you.
And then my good friend Jeremy Winston, who serves here now. Jeremy and I sang in the Aeolians together. And we had a great time between the years, what years was that, 97 and 99, that's when I was there. Right, something like that, whatever. We're old people now. And so good to see Jeremy. You know what, Jeremy? This is real risky, but I'm going to do it. No. Jeremy, come. This is risky. Don't try this at home, yeah?
I'll pay him back someday.
My faith has found a resting place, not in a man-made creed. I trust the ever-living one, that he for me will plead. I need no other evidence. I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died and rose again for me.
The lost he came to.
Don't try that at home, okay? It's very, very dangerous. Before we sing our last song, I also just want to acknowledge, I saw him, one of our associate professors of religion and theology at Oakwood University and the director of the Bradford Cleveland Brooks Institute, Pastor Dr. Jesse Wilson. And a gentleman who many of you have met before, he's been here before, but on, what day was that? I think it was Monday. Monday he got a new title, pastor's dissertation, Dr. Vilroy McBean. Who, Vilroy serves as our manager and makes sure we get to where we need to be, wherever that may be. Let me just tell you something interesting before we sing this last song. I was telling some people at intermission, this has been a very strange semester for us in some ways, and I'll tell you why. We have a lot of different projects and things that we are working on. It felt pretty good. So one of the idea who they're listening to, and the committee says, oh, we want this choir, this choir, this choir. So for the first time in all these 70-something years, the Oakwood Aeolians will be singing at the National Convention for the American Choral Directors Association. So because of that, you can imagine, and that's like 25 minutes of the most important music we'll ever do in our lives. It's 25 minutes. It's going to go like this. But we've been practicing that music all night long, all night, like all the time. Some difficult music, some Bach, and some other things. Some things that will not be ready till February. So pray for us as we do that. The convention will be in Kansas, Missouri. If you want to come, go to ACDA, American Choral Directors Association, and it will come up. So we've been working on a lot of things. And I'm prefacing this because this next song, for all the new people in the choir, new people raise your hands, we have not had a chance to rehearse this with them, so I'm praying for them right now. This is a song we haven't sung all semester, but I'm confident that we can make it through. Thank you so much for coming out this evening. It's been a true joy. We'll be with you tomorrow for church, I believe, and we love worshiping here in a great space. Can I take this thing with me? It's so awesome. It's so awesome. So let's do this. Ladies, how about you come out in the aisles for me? Let's do that. And if you knew, stay by somebody all that could lead you through. And guys, just kind of spread out, kind of like you did for the first tune, yeah? And while they're moving, can I just thank the person on the piano, Dr. Wayne Buckner? So don't try this at home either. All right. And let me not forget to thank the person who I got so many emails from, Courtney. Where's Courtney right now? Courtney, thank you so much for all your coordination. And where's Pastor Alex? Where's Alex? Is she in the room? Oh, she's right there. Alex, thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right, here goes nothing. Thank you.
We want to thank again Oakwood University Aeolians. Again, we want to welcome you to worship with us tomorrow morning at 11:15. But if we can, we're going to have one service at 11:15. Sabbath school will be at 10 a.m. And if we can all just, our hearts have been filled this evening, have they not? And we're certainly thankful again to Oakwood University Aeolians, and we're happy that you got your first concert here. So we got the best of the year. And we know that there's more things to come, and we're thankful so much for everything that you've done. And we just want to close with a brief word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this evening and for what our hearts have felt and what our ears have heard. We've been touched by the gift of music and by the blessings of these beautiful voices, and we just want to say thank you for this evening. Go with them and all that they do as they travel not only across this country but across the world as ambassadors for you. Be with us now as we go to our separate places, and bring us back here safely tomorrow morning, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.